Members of the channel Messiah Revelation Ministry, you are welcome and God bless all of you for being members of this channel and also sharing the videos to all the four corners of the world. In today's video, we are focusing on George Floyd, the brother who was killed in the United States. And we are asking a simple question. We are focusing on how the death of George Floyd is fulfilling and confirming prophecies about United States and also prophecies about the world. So we are taking the fulfillment and the confirmation one by one. The first one, we say that the death of George Floyd in the United States. George Floyd was killed by a police officer. Is confirming that the United States is declining. And you can see what happened during or after the death of George Floyd. News coverage over the world shows the United States as a nation that is declining. In the fulfillment of the prophecies about the United States, as revealed to Prophet Daniel, is as revealed to King Nebuchadnezzar. The U.S. is declining, and the U.S. Is on the way to being a collapsed state, as fulfilled, predicted in the prophecies in the Bible, Revelation chapter 18. I believe that the U.S. is the Babylon spoken of in Revelation chapter 18. Number two, the death of George Floyd also gives evidence about the new world order and how it is being implemented. George Floyd died during the time of COVID-19 lockdown, and you also saw the anarchy that occurred as a result of the death of George Floyd. I will not blame the anarchy on the protesters. I blame the anarchy that ensued after the death of George Floyd on the architects of the new world order. Number one, they locked the US down, they locked the world down, and in a desire to topple the United States and impose the Antichrist system, they engage in anarchy. So the anarchy is being sponsored by the implementers of the new world order. It is not the protesters. It is not those who were looting. It's a spiritual exercise connected with the coming Antichrist, connected with the government of the beast, and the U.S. is metamorphosing into a beast state, leading the world towards the beast Antichrist system. This anarchy that resulted from the death of the of George Floyd is necessary for a so-called man of peace, the Antichrist, to come and to restore the anarchy, restore law and order. And so when you hear President Trump talking about law and order, he's specifically talking about a man of peace who will come and restore law and order. So George Floyd's death is being used by Satan's agents to create the next stage of the global pandemic, anarchy. And from that anarchy, they can impose a martial law, and somebody will come in to restore law and order. Unfortunately, that person will be the man of sin and the man of lawlessness, spoken of in the book of Revelation chapter 13. George Floyd's death also has showcased the key roles of the two presidents of the United States. We see two presidents ruling at the same time. President Trump, number 45, and President Obama, number 44. And you can see that Obama is resurging. He is coming into the scene gradually. And he spoke about the death of George Floyd. And he confirmed that America was born out of a revolution, and so the protest and it should continue to challenge the system that has denied rights to African Americans. So you see Obama coming back, and it confirms the vision that I have that Obama's rule is still significant, is relevant, and he has not finished yet. And I believe that he is part of the new world order and the Antichrist system, in the same way that President Trump, number 45, is part of the new world order. Let's focus on Trump. You already had my video where I had a vision about Trump signing the rare world order. Symbolically, is the new world order. The vision that I had on July 20th, 2018. Trump is part of the new world order, and he is the president who signed it. It's a mystery that was revealed to me. It's no wonder that George Floyd's death occurred during the presidency of Donald Trump, number 45, who is part of the Antichrist beast system. As a result of the death of George Floyd, you also saw how President Trump handled it. His relationship with the military and the police, and how he deployed the beast army, the beast police, to confront the protesters or the people he called the thugs in the United States. It confirms a vision that I had where I saw President Trump handing over power to the military. And so George Floyd's death is confirming the vision I had that Trump will be working or is working in close cooperation or collaboration with America's police, states, and America's military. That shows that is not someone to be trusted as a part of the beast system, and he is doing things that is inflating or inflaming the situation leading to anarchy in the United States. That is a beginning of a beast system, the Antichrist system. So the death of George Floyd has actually shown the true colors of Donald Trump, the US president, the man who signed the New World Order in a vision that the Lord showed to me. When you saw him holding a Bible close to the White House in front of a church, that is a distraction, is a delusion. Of course, the man of sin, the Antichrist, will come pretending to be a man of God, a man of peace, but later on he'll show his true characters. I'm not saying that Trump is the man of lawlessness, the man of sin, the Antichrist. I'm confidently saying that President Trump, who signed the Satanic New World Order, is part of the Antichrist system. And it is no wonder that God is confirming that he's part of it. And COVID-19 came during his presidency. And the lockdown of the United States came during his presidency. And the killing of George Floyd came during his presidency. And the unprecedented anarchy in the United States came during his presidency. And so his slogan is confirming that he is not a man of peace, and he cannot be a godly person, and he cannot be a Cyrus, as so many false prophets have claimed. The next question we ask ourselves is Trump. What will he do? And I've already done a video where I saw President Trump handing over power to a four-star general. I've already done a video about it. And with the death of George Floyd, you see how Trump, the president, used the military and the National Guard to trample on the rights of people who were protesting. And so is that confirming the vision I had, that Trump will hand over power to the military? Partly, yes. But symbolically, it also means that Trump has ceded power to an authority higher than him. Obviously, it's a satanic authority in preparation for the coming of the Antichrist and the rise of the beast state in the United States. So Trump handing over power to the military is confirmed about the Trump policies on the protesters and how he deployed National Guards in states, how he deployed the police, and how he treated those who were protesting. Is confirming, George Floyd's death is confirming that Trump, of course, will rely on the military, the police state to achieve his objectives. Definitely he's part of the beast Antichrist system. Now, George Floyd is dead. Will America come back to normal? Will things normalize? And I would say no. Why do I say that? I say that because America doesn't have time to repent. The time for the desolation of America is now. I've already done a video where I heard a voice that Russia is going to attack the United States. I believe that that event is coming. I confidently say that the U.S. Will be attacked and destroyed. And in the vision that I had, it was during the time of a Russian leader with a KGB background. So I believe that there will be an attack on the United States. Predictably, it is likely will come during the time of Putin. And definitely that was how I saw it in a vision. So the death of George Floyd and whatever happened after that, the lawlessness, the anarchy, is a precursor of the coming judgment on the United States. Interestingly, all these things are happening at a time where the final trumpet of heaven has sounded. And so the death of George Floyd is a warning about the coming judgment, not only on the United States, but the judgment on the world as Jesus Christ prepares to descend to judge the world. If you have not accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, today is the day for you to do so. Thank you.